not dead, he's surely alive. He's living on the inside, roaring like a lion. God's not dead, surely alive.
I grew up in a very, very God-based, faith-focused Christian home. With my mother, obviously. whose faith I literally believe can move mountains. And I was taken away to the land of Egypt, away from my family, my friends, my church, and those who loved and cared about my well-being. Throughout my time in Egypt, I became less and less sure of my faith and more attracted to the splendor of the evil one. Then one day I reached a turning point. My faith one night was put through the ultimate personal test, and the next morning I decided for myself that God did not exist. After that night, I spent the next almost 15 years of my life wandering in circles in the desert like Moses. I was incredibly angry, I was hurt, I was very confused. I was lost, and I was so blind that I could no longer see the truth. As I entered into my adult years, I learned how to dull my pain through multiple forms of chemical stimulation. For a while, like most lies from the deceiver, I seemingly felt better. It felt good to get back at those who had hurt me by experimenting and living blindly, doing what I physically desired and living in any sinful fashion that tickled my fancy. True joy had left me, happiness had become an unattainable concept, and despair ate up every waking hour of my seemingly meaningless existence. God brought me people into my life who cared about me, even when I didn't. He brought me closer to my He brought me closer to my family than I had ever been before. Whew. One of the biggest things that he did for me was make me realize that the chemical stimulation that I had depended on to ease my pain was actually causing a great deal of it. So one night, I decided to be done with it. I'm not pretending that this was easy at all to give up. But for the first time in my adult life, I wanted to get better. I then began to think back of the time when I had decided that God didn't exist. And that was the time that it actually hit me. I realized in that moment that God had been there with me all along. I instantly wanted answers. I searched out, I found my Bible, and I started digging. I wanted to know what it said as an adult with a sound mind. That Sunday, I went to church for the first time in 15 years, consensually. I heard his sermon on the different paths that life offers us. There's our path, and there's God's path. At the end of the service, I put on my sunglasses and I made a beeline for the exit. When I got home and for the next few days, I continued digging in my Bible. Then one night, I asked my kid sister if she wanted to watch a movie. She said, come on over, but we never watched that movie. We began talking about God, and I began asking questions. My sister and my soon-to-be, thank you Jesus, brother-in-law began answering the questions that I had, and it was there at his dining room table that I accepted Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. Today,
amen.
Today I'm forgiven, and today I'm free, and today I want to share the good news with the world.
Before God came into my life, I wasn't making very good decisions. But now that God's in my life, he's helped me to make better decisions.